Hello, everybody out there. Laz once again. The topic of today's conversation, discussion, is going to be IT jobs and IT and overall job requirements. I was looking, well, before we get into it, I just want to show you, I'm sharing my Globed webpage, okay? Right now, I'm going to put my face in here. Right now on the Globed webpage, all right, you know we have all these courses, switching courses, IP courses that I know you need, switching courses that I know you need, all right? We have the Network Plus, okay? We have the CCNAs, the Deluxe one, which is very detailed oriented, the older certifications, which are still valid in the sense that information that's there, okay? We have a promotion right now with January Surprise promo code. January surprise promo code that will give you 69% off. All right. Today is the last day, 24 hours. You got 24 hours as of today. It's been there since Sunday. All right. So if you haven't gotten it, take advantage of it now, because one of the people that get it, they'll be put into my private Facebook group. And then I will send those people that use the January surprise code and bought one of my self-paced courses at 69% off, I will send them an invitation to go onto Zoom to do a free webinar on the CCNA, a Q&A. So it'll be a question, you know, where are you weak on, what have you. So take advantage of that. So go to Globed right now, okay? Get a course that you think you would need. And I know everybody right now needs to do this right here. They get plenty of the book. Yeah, everybody needs that. Okay. And definitely switching, everybody needs that. All right. Because I get into spine and leaf and all that good stuff. All right. So you can get 69% off that right now. You get into my private Facebook and I'll send you an email when I see all the people there already and this is over. I'll send an email when we're going to do a webinar for free. All right. With the Q&A. It's a Q&A type of thing. So Don't miss out. All right. But anyway, one of the things that I want to talk about today is, like, I got to applaud all of you guys. Every person out there in IT, I applaud you. I completely respect everybody out there. I don't care what part of IT you're in, whether it's programming, web design, networking, repair, refurbish, anything that you're doing in IT, IT related fields. What's up, Albert? From Belgium. What is up? Okay. So us in the IT world, we invest our soul into our careers because IT is a career. It's not just a job. It's an adventure. No, it's a career. It's a career. Okay. Just by getting your CompTIA, like your A+, your Network Plus, your Security Plus, your Linux Plus, getting a Cisco, a CCNA, let's say a Microsoft, you invested easily $2,000, okay? A lot cheaper than any friggin' degree will get you, right? And you won't be left without with a loan. But you have, you know, invested $2,000, $3,000, depending on how many IT certifications you require. Because you want to get cloud, you want to get all these different types of certifications in security and all this other stuff. So, and now we got to get into programming and get to learning Ansible and all this. So there's a lot of knowledge. If it wasn't for IT personnel that exist out there working in data centers, ISPs, networks in general, whether it be small to enterprise networks, companies could not do what they do, right? These are individuals that are dedicated, that are passionate, that are hungry, that are working, they're communicating the world, okay? And we're getting gypped. Okay, because I looked at this today, and let me show you this. It's going to upset you. It's going to, like, what? This is in Orlando, Florida, where I looked this up. Orlando, Florida jobs, okay? So I looked up an IT help desk job, okay? Let me share it with you. An IT help desk job, look at this. 13 to 15 an hour. You see this, right? You need at least, preferred, 2 years of experience. Okay. So let me make this a little bit smaller because I haven't zoomed in so big. Oop, too small. Well, I can always move it around. So as an IT assistant for whatever, whatever, Orlando assistant duties, responsibilities, go over responsibilities. Deploy and set up desktop computer systems, okay? Retrieve and organize equipment stock. Install, what's up, son? What is that? McCall? Son McCall? What's up, what's up, what's up? Okay, good to see you. Install various software, general end users report, ensuring all calls are answered, interacting with internal, whatever, blah, 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 and other duties required. Okay, good communication and customer skills. Attention to detail, good decision-making skills. Proficient in office, okay? Ability to work in the team, okay? Excellent oral skill, oral and written skills. Customer service experience, a plus, all right? And then it comes down here and it starts talking about you better have an A-plus certification. That's a requirement. You better have an A-plus certification. You better have knowledge of Windows 7, Windows 10, Windows 7, Windows 10, and the entire MS Office suite. Mobile devices, phones, tablets, laptops, including mobile OS platforms, functionalities, okay? Must be self-motivated, ability to lift 50 pounds, whatever. Be able to travel, 9 to 5, okay? And it's based on experience. So they're willing to pay you $13 to $15 an hour. $15 an hour is $31,200, okay? $15 an hour at 40 hours is $31,200. Today's world. That's where IT help does. Not done. Okay? Then we got IT support tech. Here's a little bit better. $20 to $35 an hour. Okay. And but again, you gotta know this is a contracting job. Help desk, our services include help desk, remote troubleshooting, on-site troubleshooting, system setup, networking, and networking admin software. Okay, so 5 years. Okay, here, minimum 5 year experience working with companies, managed service provider, 5 years of various IT services, bachelor's degree preferred, ability to support work, multi-user systems, whatever. I mean, Windows PC, look at these. You need an old server from 2003 already to 2016, Windows 10, 8, 7, Vista, XP, SQL, FTP, IIS, web servers, SSL, Exchange, virtualization. I mean, look at this. It's a contract, most work 10 to 15 hours a week, okay? Professional references, all sorts of craziness, right? So here it is for these jobs, all right? And it says 20, let me go back up, sorry. Let me put my little face in here, okay? They're talking about 20 to 35 an hour. I'm gonna put $20 an hour, okay? $20 an hour, I'm gonna open up the calculator. Oh, that was wrong. Wow, I spelled that thing completely wrong. Let me put it over here, calculator. And we're gonna put 20 times 40, let's say 40 hours a week, right? 800 times 52 weeks a year. That's 41,600. That's $20 an hour. $20 an hour. 41,600. When I worked at a technical school for IT, teaching Cisco and Microsoft, okay, I got paid 41,000. All right. I had all these certifications in Microsoft and Cisco. Okay, A+, all network plus, all these certifications, and I have proved that I can teach before they gave me the job. But I needed all these things, right? 41,600. It's like, whoa, what's going on here? You know what I mean? Hey, what's up, Dremac? I hope I said that correct. Dremac, all right? Because I'm seeing this, I'm like, really? But now I want to show you something else. I want to show you something else. One last job. I'm going to show you one last job, but I won't do it anymore. Okay. All right, here. Well, there's two actual. One's a picture and one's a Word document. Where's the picture? That's the calculator. Let's close those calculators. Where's the freaking picture? Where's the picture? Did I close it? Well, I opened it if anything. Okay, so let me show you this. Okay. McDonald's. McDonald's. I'll tell you why I'm subscription. Where's the requirements here? Oh, here we go, requirements. We believe letting you, if you're looking for part-time job supports full-time ambition, you'll find that McDonald's crew can help you grow. Here we go. Connect with customers to ensure they have a positive experience. Help customers and their favorite McDonald's meals. Prepare our food and partner with other crew managers that meet the daily goals and have fun. Outstanding attitude, willingness to learn and grow, and the capability to excel in a fast-paced team environment will teach you the rest. Must be 16 years or older. The reason I show you this is because that's a fast food restaurants. It's always been the case that people that work in restaurants, right, they're based on tips, you know, and they get fluff, okay? Yeah, exactly, fluff, crap. Hey, Martin, what's up, bro? Abraham, what's up, Danny, how you doing? All right, the whole thing is this. You start with $20 as a contractor and all the stuff that you need to know, you're only getting paid $41,600 as a contractor. That's BS. But yet, I don't know if you guys ever heard about Amendment 2 and the minimum wage, because let me show you a little picture here. Oh, here it is. I got the picture. Do you see the picture? No? Let me show you the picture. Here's a friggin' average salary of a McDonald's crew member, because you got to be over 16 years old to be a crew member. Average salary, they can make up to, let me put it even bigger. Yeah, but that's $27,000 is high. $20,000. $27,000 to flip burgers. Okay? No A plus, no degree needed, nothing. Okay? You know, I'm cool with everybody making money, doing whatever they need to do. We all have to, you know, at one point in time, we were all there. I know in high school, I worked at Burger King for 3 years. The whole time I was in high school, back then high school was in ninth grade. It was 10th, 11th, and 12th. And I worked all my 3 years at Burger King at $3.10 an hour. I think I made it up to $3.35 an hour way back then. Okay? That's fine. I had no skills. Zero skills. Okay? Zero skills. Nobody whining. Okay? Everybody, you're lucky. You're a teenager. You're lucky to have a job. Okay? You have no skill set. You have zero experience in anything. Okay? And I see my IT brothers and sisters out here sweating it, paying for certifications, getting all these classes, going out there, trying to meet all these different requirements, and they're getting paid $41,600 or $32,000. Listen, teaching, I've told you guys, I haven't lied to you. In teaching, when I first started teaching, and I have my certifications, I am a Microsoft Office specialist. I have my expert level certifications in the Office suite, okay? I had to get it because I taught it when I first started. Okay, and I have my Cisco, and I have my Microsoft, and I have my CompTIA's. All right, that costs money. I worked at McDonald's in college and freshman, and I did not have skills. Exactly, but this is what I don't agree with. Okay, because apparently, you know, right now the minimum wage in Florida is $8 and something. I have that here in a notepad file somewhere. Okay, right here. Okay, let me show it to you real quick. Florida's minimum wage right now is January 1st, 2021. Florida's minimum wage will rise from the current rate of $8.56 to $8.65. But it's not going to stop there, ladies and gentlemen. In the next 10 years, I believe it is, they want to raise it to $15 an hour. So you could be working at McDonald's for $15 an hour. Okay, I'll accept that if you raise the requirements. Because if we in IT need to have excellent communication and oral, you know, written and oral skills. We need to have bachelor's degrees. Well, then, you know what? In order to work at McDonald's, you need to have, because to get into the military, all right, now, all right, because I tried to get my daughter into the military and I went to talk to recruiters when, you know, when she was graduating high school, you know, she falls in this generation. You need to have 15 college credits. You need to have good credit. The BMI, based on your height, age, whatever, okay? You need to follow the BMI. They're very strict on who can get in, all right? But 15 college credits, okay, to join the military. 15 college credits and good credit. And they're going to check your backgrounds, okay? So, and that's what they do with people in IT. If you're going to go for a security position, if you have your security plus, you have your CISSP, you have your ethical hacking, you have all these major security, your CISA, all this, all right, all this security certifications, if you want to apply for higher levels of security, they check you all the way down to you were born. You know, was the nurse that birthed you? Was he an okay baby? You know, they're going to do that kind of stuff to you. Hey, lads, what's up, Anthony? How you doing, brother? Anthony's on board, ladies and gentlemen. Anthony's on board. Okay. you know, they're gonna stretch your background all the way to the back you were born. They're gonna make you say, well, you need to have at least an AS. You need to have a bachelor's. It used to be that. Well, you, where's your CCNA? Where's your A plus or Never plus, your Security plus? All this stuff that you need to have, and then you better present yourself as a nice person. Hey, how are you? How you doing? Oh, nice. Well, wonderful to be here. You gotta do all these back. You gotta do all this research on the company you're gonna go to. We do these resumes and whatever. I got no issues with that. We play the game. We got to play the game, right? We got to play the game, but pay me for it. Don't pay me just enough. Somebody that's working at McDonald's flipping burgers. I flip burgers at Burger King and McDonald's, as a matter of fact. I lasted at McDonald's for 6 months. I said, this is insane, and went back to Burger King. Okay? I worked it all my whole high school years. Thank you, FaZe. I appreciate that, brother. Okay? So I just find that ridiculous. So if we're upping the minimum wage, we're upping, let's up it equally to everyone. Let's bring it up. Let's pay people what they're worth. Okay. And then if we're going to up minimum wage, okay, cool. You know, everybody deserves the right to make a decent, you know, decent amount of money. All right. I mean, $31,000 for a freaking teenager living at home with mom and dad, that's more than enough. Okay. My mom and dad are paying all the freaking bills, but let's say whatever, they're getting paid that. Cool. Got no issues. Up the requirements. You need to have good customer service skills. When you come to a friggin' interview, okay? When you come to an interview, you better be shaven. You better be in pants, nice shoes, and a shirt, a polo at least, okay? Don't be coming in with shorts and flip-flops and, you know, and I want you to do your research on McDonald's. I want you to know when McDonald's, how McDonald's was created. You want to find a career? You're looking for a job? What is your purpose of being here? You got to put them through the ringer, okay? Because if I'm paying you $15 an hour, okay, you're up there, 27 grand, right? $27,000. All right, you can make at McDonald's as a crew member. How can I help you today? They don't even tell you that. There is no customer service. When I was in working at Burger King, it was like, welcome to Burger King. This, good morning, ma'am or sir. Welcome to Burger King. How may I take your order? Okay, would you like this with that? Would you like that? Well, please, this is your total. Drive on through. Thank you. You know, and it was like that, and you were timed. As soon as somebody, you had 30 seconds to a drive-through, 1 minute to walk in through the door, okay? And we had our district managers coming down, timing us, checking the temperature. This is not happening today. I see people walking around like this. Here. People ask me, here, anything else? Anything else? Anything else? So if you're going to up it for IT people that are paying thousands of dollars in their certifications, which is maybe up to, let's say, anywhere between $1,000 to $3,000, and you have all you need to go out there, right? We are studying our butts off and labbing our brains out. We've locked ourselves up in a room or a closet somewhere so we can do what we need to do, so we can have a career, so we can be productive and effective. The desire and passion of everybody on this channel right now, everybody who's going to view it, everybody that knows, has been my student, they have the drive of a lion. They have the passion and the hunger to get what they want, and they're having such a freaking hard time with these HR departments and all this nonsense, these employers that are scared to death because this IT individual knows more than they do. Hire that person. You don't have to micromanage them, okay? But it's upsetting because I looked at that today. I said, you know what? This is not right, because, you know, I do go to McDonald's very so often. And get me my little happy meal, whatever, you know, no, my cheat days, my real cheat days, because I cheat every day, but, you know, my real cheat days, all right? And I see them with no enthusiasm, because you have to make a good connect with a customer so they can have good quality of experience. Obviously, they don't know what QOE or QoS means, okay? They don't, not that they should, but hold them to the same standard that you hold us, because you're dealing with the public. If you deal with outsourcing help desk, if you're dealing with clients, if you're working at a cell center, whatever, Verizon, where they sell phones, all right? If you're there, you're going to be like, what do you want? No, yeah, this phone's pretty good. Yeah, how much it cost? $500. And that's how you are, really? And like, oh, welcome to Metro PCS. How may I help you? Okay, well, yeah, we have a variety of phones that can help you. What is it that you're really looking for? This is how you create the relationship with a customer, All right. You don't talk down to customers. You don't, you're not condescending. You're not aggressive. You have, you know, you relax. You're empathetic. Okay. You're trying to help them. Here they are coming for lunch. They're hungry. They have 30 minutes or an hour to get their lunch. Hi, how may I help you? How can I take your order? What would you like? Sure, no problem. But not have a 20-minute conversation because you're playing World of Warcraft or you went out last night and you guys are buddies and you're shooting the crap out there. And that's no. That is, I have seen it in front of me where they're making out in the behind the register. And these people are getting paid $27,000. Hello? Hello? 20 to 27,000 medium. Hardly anybody gets low. Maybe the 15-year-olds get paid that, okay? But you're talking about a 16-year-old, 17-year-old, 18-year-old that may be getting paid 27,000 and maybe later on maybe getting paid close to 30,000. When I, to teach at a career college, McDonald's workers today act like they're doing you a favor. Yup. Yup. Exactly. All right. And here I am teaching. I'm about to teach A plus certificate. That's why I started teaching in career colleges. It was A plus. All A plus stuff, right? Computer repair, computer maintenance, all these different things dealing with customer service skills. Because you needed it back then, right? At a college, at a career college, right? I had to teach that. But I had to have all these certifications. I had the principal, the vice principal, teachers, at doing the teach test in front of them to see if I was good enough to teach at their college. So they put me through the ringer, and that's well done. Well done, right? Because you want good educators in front of the students. But damn it, hold everybody to the same level. If you're hiring people that are going to be doing customer service and they're eventually going to get paid $15 an hour, I don't have an issue with that, but then up the requirements. I didn't say the requirements in that thing. We're just going to have fun and you need to connect with your customers. No, you need to come in properly dressed for an interview. I need to see a resume, whether you're not going to have crap on it, okay? And you need to prove yourself, that 90-day probationary period. What happened to that? Okay, what happened to that? You have a 90-day probationary period if you make the cut or not. Do you know? I used to work in warehousing. Okay, do you know how many people at the 90-day point they fired because they didn't want to make you a full-time employee? They wanted to pay the benefits. People that busted their butts day in and day out, they didn't hire them. And these are adults that have families that they got to take care of. Okay. And I'm not saying there's certain teenagers out there. I'm not trying to pick on teenagers. I'm looking at the pay scale and versus the requirements, you know, I just told you, I showed you right now, a contractor that needs to know a world of things and have that experience. And he's getting paid $41,600. I was getting paid $41,000. I don't know how many years ago, $41,000 to teach Cisco. 600, these people are paying $600 more. What, like 10 years ago? Only an extra $600, and you gotta know all this technology and you better have experience at a BS preferred? That's ridiculous. That's ridiculous, okay? You wanna have those requirements? Then you'd be paying me at least $60 a year. At least, minimum. Bottom of the barrel, $60,000. And if I'm a contractor, you're not giving me any benefits. How about paying me $90,000? Okay? You're not paying me any benefits. You're not paying me anything but straight hour, right? Hourly pay. And as an I-9 form, I pay for my own taxes. So you're not paying me any benefits. You're not paying me anything. Pay me $90,000, especially for all the knowledge that you want me to know. Pay me what I'm worth. Everybody here is worth minimum $90,000. If you're in IT, I don't care what you're doing, Photoshop, web design, programming, networking, hardware. I don't care. We IT individuals make the country, the world run. We make everybody able to communicate with each other, share information, make sure all these computers, switches, routers, cabling, all these things are being checked daily, backed up daily. All right. Imagine the medical records in a hospital. You know what would happen if IT personnel said, hell with it, done. What? Imagine everybody walked out of Facebook. No one teaches the IT pro how to sell themselves. That's true. And one of the things is as far as being, you know, you first of all, you need to walk in anywhere you go confident. You know your skills. And I keep telling you guys, guys have taken my boot camps, guys have taken my courses, and they've asked me questions here on the live or one-on-one when I used to do that one-on-one for free for an hour. You need to be confident. You have the skill. No, lies, I don't have the experience. What experience? I'm so tired of this real world crap. Okay, you haven't been in the real world. What? One gentleman, Chris Brooks, layer 8 issues. That's his term. I learned it from him, Chris Brooks. That's the user. You don't have users that are screwing things up on a daily basis. Or you have the higher ups changing things on you on a daily basis. That's real world. There you go. And then real world changes from network to network to network to network to network to network. If you work on one company all your life, you know what that one company does. That's it. Whatever technology they use, whatever policies they do, whatever equipment they have, that's what you know. I take you from that environment and put you, let's say, in Jolie's environment, you're done. Done. And as far as what my wife is putting there as customer service is key. I worked with Bell South. It was 3 months worth of customer service training. All right. One of the things that they teach you in customer service training, all right, is close your eyes. You don't want to put customers on hold. I want you, don't do it now, all right? Do it when we're done. Close your eyes. And you're supposed to keep people on hold for 2 minutes, no longer than that. 2 minutes. If you close your eyes, you can't have your eyes closed for 30 seconds unless you fall asleep. Because you're like, where the hell are these people? What's going on? Okay, so you check back with it. Oh, I'm so sorry. I'm taking so long. I do appreciate you waiting. We're just looking into it right now with my manager. If you can give me a little bit more time, can I place you on hold again? Sure. All right. Thank you so much. I appreciate your patience. I'll be right back with you. You check in with your customer. You got to have good customer service skills. Young people, I mean, there could be a percentage of teenagers that are, you know, they're out there and they're very respectful. And I've seen them. They're very respectful. They're very whatever because they understand. Okay. But for the majority, no. I've seen it working all these fast food places. They just don't care. I think I've been in a restaurant, not a fast food restaurant, a restaurant, okay? This one waitress, oh my God, smile, the best. I never tip under 20%. I always tip 20. I think I did one time, I tipped her 30, okay? Because she was that good. Me, my wife, I think my stepdaughter was there too. And it was like, wow, what customer, my day was brightened because of this person, even more so. Okay, that's just the way it should be. Okay, you're doing a job. All right, it sucks. You know, we got to do what we can, right? We got to do what we can with what we have at that time. When I was a kid, all my skill set, okay, I work at Burger King. I was the shit at Burger King though, because they would call me in, Last King, coming to work, man. Last King work. Last was working one day. I worked from 5 a.m. to 5 a.m. because they didn't have anybody else. I worked 24 hours. And they would just fix my time card because I was underage. But I remember myself in English class like this. But $3.10 an hour, yeah, my paycheck was pretty decent because I worked the hours. Okay. And I still did cross country. I still did swimming. Okay. I still did track and did my schoolwork. Not so good, but I still did it. Okay. I passed. Okay. But the point is that, you know, I see all these things, all these minimum wage coming up, but I don't see requirements coming up. If the minimum wage comes up, cool, all right. It's going to be harder on employers, but if I was an employer and they're making me pay somebody $15 to flip burgers, no problem. I'm going to increase the requirements. You need to have, like I said, 15 college credits. If you're in high school, you have to have a 3.5 GPA. When you come to the interview, you better be well-dressed. You better be articulate, okay, professional. And if in the 90-day period, I don't see it, you will be reviewed every month. And if you're not up to par with what I need for my particular franchise, you're done. I agree with you, Laz. As long as you're labbing it, you should have experience. You have experience. For example, adding a subnet in the routing table in the lab, it can be added immediately in companies, they do change control. Yeah, they do change control, you know, and that's the whole thing. And it is, you have to lab things up. I did in my last boot camp. I did a lab where there were certain things that I broke on purpose, and I had them, you know, do, okay, where do you look? Where do you see? Where do you find? So I did that. And Mr. Brooks, he's the one, hey man, you should do stuff like this and put it out there so people will know what to look for. And I go, you give me an idea. All right. So I'm going to go ahead and start doing stuff like that. And when you come to me, Because right now I'm doing an IP master class. Okay. I'm doing an IP master class and it's going to be from scratch and I'm not giving anybody any labs. Okay. So you better be paying attention because there will be quizzes and you won't be able to go to the next section unless you actually have, you pass the first quiz on section one. And it's going to be like that. There's several sections. Okay. So if you lab, I want your lab from scratch so you can make mistakes. And again, when people come to my boot camps, they're going to be in the hot seat. They're going to configure because it's always the famous question. Are you guys okay? Do you understand the concept? Do you understand how you're doing? Yes. Okay. Let's see. Poop, clear out, do a topology. All right, Martin, configure. And then you're like, what? Wait a minute. Because I'm going to put you in the hot seat. I have to be accountable for the information that I give you, but you need to be accountable for the learning part of it. You need to take your notes. You need to lab things up. You need to read the chapter. You need to do the review questions. You need to set up crazy labs. Your imagination is your limitation. Create these labs. If you go to work, if you're already a 19, you're trying to get your certs, mimic your labs from work at your packet tracer, or in your Eve, or in your Virl, wherever the hell you're using. Just configure it, okay? But to me, I'm noticing these things. I just noticed it really yesterday, and I've been dying to do this today. Where it's like, wait a minute, I helped this guy $13 to $15 an hour. Are you serious? You're putting him in the same category as somebody's gonna go flip burgers? Okay, no, man, no. Listen, I've worked at McDonald's, Burger King. I've worked at construction, retail. I've done warehousing, okay? Surveying and mapping, okay? I've done all the blue collar, hard work labor. I'm the one that used to make fun of people that worked in offices in front of computers. I don't have the same mindset now. People that use this, all right, when this goes and your mind is tired, yeah, your body's not going to go to the gym, okay? If you're tired from construction, take a pre-workout, go back to the gym, and you're good to go because you didn't really use your brain that much, okay? It's just a matter of just looking through this little instrument, taping off. You know, it's hard work, back-busting work, yes, but your brain is really not that exhausted. But if your brain's exhausted because you're trying to develop this database, you're doing these configurations, you're trying to do a list, the Cisco DNA, all these crazy stuff now, all these VMware and virtualization type things that's going on. So, and now you gotta learn programming on top of that. You've been looking at code all friggin' day. It's like, you know, for 8 hours straight, maybe longer. But man, I can't go to the gym today. I just can't. My brain's fried. I can't even count reps. You know what I mean? So it's like, they need to bring up the requirements. That's my bottom line. Who here agrees or disagrees with me? I believe that if you bring up the minimum wage for everyone, let's say for IT, for everybody, bring it up, right? Let that contractor, instead of getting paid 41, like I really believe everybody here should be getting paid 90 grand, bottom of the, that's it. That's your IT. I don't care where you're at, 90 grand. Because you got to get A+, A+, security plus, okay? And a Cisco. I don't care if you're going to go to help desk. Okay. I don't care. All right. You need at least to put all those certs in there. Okay. And they're going to ask you and they want a bachelor's on top of that. Okay. So 90 grand bottom of the barrel. That's what you need to be paying me. That is what you need to be paying me. Amen. Yes. It makes the world happen. What is it? So true. It makes the world happen nowadays. All right. Thank you. You agree with me. Awesome. Okay. And then now if we're going to, cause this money is coming out of somewhere. Thank you, Martin. I think, you know, this money's coming out of somewhere to up the minimum wage. Who's going to be paying for this? Because employers, they're like, oh my God, I got to pay $15 an hour to this 16-year-old kid that's coming over here just to freaking, you know, ding, fries ready. You know what I mean? It's like, really? Come on, man. I worked there. I know. We have more catch-up fights. I had tons of fun when I worked there working, all right, and during high school. It was fun. And I worked long hours because I was getting paid $3.10 an hour. So I wanted to make as much money as I could, but I was almost into the management before I those 3 years, end of my senior year, they were looking for me to be into management, but I went into the service because I didn't even go to college. I didn't want to go to college. Okay. I was just like that. But anyway, but it's ridiculous. It's ridiculous that they're putting us IT people. Help desk. You know how much I worked at the Answer Group? It was an outsourced help desk. I'll never forget. I had all these certifications and I brought them in just to show off, not show off, but you know, to show, hey, look, I got this. I know what I'm doing, right? first day, they had a thing like 2 week training or 1 week training. And there was 1 week training, 1 week shadowing, and then you're on your own. And then the first question that the guy, I mean, this is back, oh my God. And we were still troubleshooting NT4. All right. And the guy goes, okay, you're in Windows 98, whatever. And the guy goes, what happens if somebody calls and says they can't hear the sound? You can underpaying an IT engineer, it should be a crime. Yes, it should be a friggin' felony. Okay. It should be a felony. All right. Every IT individual, especially, you know, every IT individual, period. We are the backbone of these companies. Last, what do you think of some companies putting junior engineers on help desk get used to the work pressure in their first month? Listen, I don't mind that at all. I don't mind that at all that you switch up. As a matter of fact, the gentleman, Chris Brooks, he would do that. He had that thing where he will get the top level engineers, put them on help desk and take the help desk engineers and put them in their spot. All right. So they can see how hectic that is. So they can see what's going on. So everybody needs to be cross-trained in everything. So that's a good idea. I agree with that. I agree with that. Just so they can see what's going on, because everybody belittles the help desk person, the person that's just saying, let me finish my train of thought. But yes, I do agree with that. I do agree getting these top level engineers that they're so comfortable and click, hey, Bob, take care of that for me, okay? Thank you. Hey, Susie, yeah, did you send that in? Yeah. No, okay? You need to start doing the work. You need to get off that chair and start, oh, okay, let me check this, let me check that, let me do this, let me do that. Because when they told me, what do you do if somebody calls you? How would you attack the problem if somebody calls you and they said, I can't hear it, I have no sound? The first thing that came to my mind, fresh out of school, no experience, oh, the device manager, the driver, this, how about turning up the volume? How about unmuting yourself? How about checking the cable if it's even plugged in? Okay, how about doing that? Okay, so I'm like, damn, he's right. So you go for the easy stuff first, but you don't get that off out of school. Out of school, you just came out of all this advanced stuff. So you're thinking about the registry, you're thinking about all sorts of crazy stuff. And all you gotta do is just turn up the volume. My headset's not working, plug it in. I can't hear you, lads. Unmute yourself. You see what I'm saying? Okay, this is the kind of thing, but that comes again with experience. That comes with experience. And that's what doing this undercover boss. Exactly. Oh my God. Exactly. But yes, when I went through help desk, I went through hell and back and I loved it. That was a boot camp for me to understand troubleshooting, how to attack an issue. That's why I tell everybody in submitting. You got the submitting question. How do you attack it? What do you look at? The ending and no, dude, look at the submit mask. That's all you need to look at. Look at the submit mask. That's all you need. Draw your line. What do you anchor with? Boom, done. Any IPv4 question should be answered under 30 seconds, period. If you're answering things, I don't know if my stepdaughter put it on Instagram, my Instagram at the networking doctors. I just put a wall card mask question on there. If you don't answer that question under 30 seconds, you're done. Hey, Laz, submit mask. Yes, submit mask. Submit mask. Kevin, what's up, Kevin? How you doing, man? We're going to be seeing each other on Wednesday. Remember, that's tomorrow, right? 2 o'clock. I think companies want you to know the company's culture and config standards. Most companies don't do best IT practices because of the need to save money. Best practices are expensive. That's true. Martin, was it you that asked me about storm control last time? I know somebody in one live. C is the answer. You're correct, Kevin. Oh, I gave it away. Somebody asked me about storm control, right? And I think I gave an answer. I said, well, I think you're talking about broadcast, right? And I looked it up about broadcast. It does deal with broadcast and how to control that. But then by just that, I was doing a boot camp, or was before the boot camp, I was getting it ready, and I was in the switch looking for storm commands, and I saw storm control. I'm like, okay, storm control, and then you can apply a percentage. Right, there's a 0.0 to 100.0, and you can apply a type of range. So there's a storm control, but you know what, Martin? That storm control is not taught in the Network Plus, is not taught in the CCNA, is not taught in the CCNP, or is not taught in the CCIE. That's something that you just need to find out about when you're out there, or have do things like this, and you know people tell you. So there's so many ways they can handle broadcast. That's just one method that's not taught anywhere, and that's what I tell people about firewalls. Who teaches you firewalls? Who? I'm lucky enough to have Adam from South Africa that's putting something together. Is it Adam? Oh my God, did I say his name? Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's Adam. All right, from South Africa. My brain is fried. From South Africa, he's going to be putting up, and we talked the other day, an excellent course for security. So he's going to be putting firewalls, all sorts of stuff in there. So we're going to be teaching that. Jolie has taught you guys with pfSense. He's got all this stuff on his stuff. So it's like, you know, we want to teach our instructors that are in here in GlobeEd.net. We want to teach off the beaten path. Jolie loves to do real world stuff. Adam wants to do real world stuff. I want to do real world stuff. Okay. Stuff that you guys have never seen. One of the things that people have never seen, it's taught. Well, it's not taught. It should be taught, but it's not. Layer three. I teach layer three spanning leaf topology all day, every day. Excuse me, got the hiccups. Okay, so this is something people need to know, how to do the SVIs, which is your gateways. Do you know why, if you put a wrong gateway and using an SVI in your access layer, why can you can still ping it? So all these different things I do. And Kem is here. If he's still here, he can vouch for that. Okay, so and tomorrow I got a huge surprise when I meet them. This is a very big lab that I've been giving them. Why? Because I want to give them more so they can be ready. Because I want everybody, when they leave me, when they leave my course, when they leave my boot camp, when they leave this live, to have information. I want to make sure that I inundate you with information as much as I possibly can. So when you give an answer, you're confident that you're going to give a logical answer or close to it. I hold myself to and you need to hold me to that. Okay. But I hold you to your part as well. That's why I didn't get irate. Like I said, you know, okay, you want to raise the minimum wage, you want to raise the salary. All right, okay, fine. But then they got to earn it. Just like people, you have to earn respect. Respect is not given, okay? You have to earn my respect, okay? Just like I got to earn your respect. Quality tutoring. Thank you, sir. I appreciate that, Kevin. Okay? If you're going, I don't care where you're going to go work. I don't care, okay? I don't care. I went to an interview one time in a warehouse with a tie, a long sleeve shirt, tie, and pants. That's how it was back in my day. All right. That's how you did things. You did things like that. You did it where it was, you had a tie, you had a shirt, how you doing, sir, ma'am, whatever. It was very professionally, professional. That's the way you need to. It doesn't matter what. Oh, I'm going to go work at freaking Hooters. I'm just going to go in jeans and flip flops and a tank top. I'm going to work it out. Well, then you should get paid and you should go work back in the kitchen and wash plates and get paid $8 an hour. All right? Because if that's your attitude when you're going to go get a job, if that's your attitude already, I'm not even going to give you the job, as a matter of fact. When I see you coming in, I'll say, no, thank you. The job's been filled. Peace out. I don't want to talk to you. Okay? That's just the way it is. And I don't care. If I hire somebody, which I have, Jesse, what's up? Hey, lads. Any knowledge you could give me to get into learning SAP technologies and practices such as ERP. So now you're gonna make me research, man. SAP, ERP. What's ERP? SAP tech. See, now I got Google. Designed to build whatever you need. Unlock SAP power features that work, learn, call, or speak to every little intelligent enterprises, SAP solutions. So apparently there's SAP.com. You know what a SAP is, right? No. Just kidding. I love best practices. Okay, bro. Oh, I love best practices because the long run, they save you from messing things up. But companies will ask you, okay, best practice, how much will that take from the company? So don't dwell on concept. 100%. Don't dwell. Well, you got to dwell on the concept when it comes to my internet. It's not so good right now. So it's just turning in circles. So Jesse, if somebody here can help Jesse with this, with SAP technologies, I really don't know. Okay. I know it's not networking, but I saw the title and figured out it was a bit related. No, that's cool, man. That's cool. Listen, if I don't know that, now you gave me something to find out. So you made me a curious cat. I want to know that. So now I couldn't log into it. There's a site that showed me SAP.com, okay, where you can start looking at stuff like that. So now I'm going to learn about that. Okay, because to me, when you say ERP, I'm thinking of EIRP, not EIGRP, but EIRP, Effective Isotropic Radiated Power, which is the force that comes out of the antenna. So I'm thinking, okay, what is this? So if you give me an acronym, if you can give me what the acronym means, maybe I can help out a little bit better, or maybe somebody here can help better. If not, go to the Discord server. There's a bunch of guys in there They're all out there in the field, enterprise level, all the way down. And so they may know something, Jesse. Just go to the Discord server. If my wife is listening, she can put the link again to the Discord server. I would appreciate it. I mean, don't dwell on what the company says. You must dwell on the concept. Okay, okay. But I mean, you do what the company tells you to do because they're the ones that are paying you. So whatever they tell you to do, you just do. Okay, no problem. Give your 2 cents. If they want to take it, that's fine. Systems, application, and products, it's all I know. Systems, applications, and products is all I know. About the SAP, Anthony, is that what you're saying? About the SAP? Enterprise Resource Practices, I believe. Okay, cool. Cool. You know what, Jesse? I'm going to look into that. I'm going to look into that. And if you can do me a favor, if you can email me at info@thenetworkingdoctors.com, I want to look that up. I want to get a little bit, at least know a little bit about it so I can talk about it intelligently. I don't want to talk about something I really don't know because I don't want to mislead you. So, but definitely, okay? I'll look at that for you, okay? And then if I have your email, you know, just email me at info@thenetworkingdoctors.com and I'll get back to you as soon as possible, okay? On that, definitely. I'll help you out, no problem. As far as work, whatever your work tells you to do, your standard operating procedures, just do it. Just do it. You give your 2 cents. When I was working, any school that I ever worked at, brick and mortar, okay, I was always involved in the IT. And I always gave my 2 cents in, right? So listen, we need to VLAN things out. They brought even the the owner of the school to sit down with me and say, listen, I think you need to VLAN things out. We're having these issues, blah, blah, blah. I spit it out for them. There's the Discord link, people. Jesse, there's the Discord link. So you may want to get that and put and propose your question on there. I always give my input, okay? Whether they take it or not, oh, well, man, you know, that's up to them. But obviously, real world and, you know, testing are two different things. When you're testing, it's concepts. It's concepts. It's like I tell people, when you're doing the Network Plus or the CCNA, you don't configure EEDGE ERP with a wildcard mask. If you do, you're going to fail. Is it a wrong? No. Thanks, Laz. Happened to catch this license. I subscribe. Will do. You got it, brother. I'm here for you. I'm going to look into it, too. And if you got any feedback, let me know. What was I saying? I forgot what I was saying. Wow. I just Laz, is it possible to have a session with you? I need help with config and all that. Of course, man. Let's set up a time this week. Okay. I think tomorrow I'm already in the morning. I have an appointment at 10. Then I'm an appointment at 2 for an hour or so. And then I'm free after that. Martin, where are you? In the United States or in the world? Where are you? Maybe there's a delay. Let me know where are you, Martin, okay? I think you have my number, okay? I don't know, or email me a time this week. I know tomorrow I'm pretty busy in the morning, in the afternoon, but maybe later in the evening. South Africa, oh shit. So it's gotta be earlier in the morning. So we can do it maybe, what's your day? What day is today, man? Today's Tuesday, right? Yeah, today's Tuesday. Wednesday, okay. Thursday, I think we can do something. Friday. Let's set up something for Thursday or Friday, and we'll do it. Just give me a time. Give me, because I know it's late where you're at right now. So give me a time, like 5 o'clock for you, or when you get out of work, 6 o'clock. I don't know. And then just tell me what time it will be for me, and we'll do it. Let's say let's do it for Friday. When you get out, let's see if you're home at by 6 o'clock your time, what time that would be for me, and we'll get it done. No problem. All right, just let me know. Email me. Within the company I work at, I noticed that a lot of seniors have 9-to-5 mentality. Yep. I want to prevent this to happening with myself because I love my job. What is your advice on this? Don't leave. Don't get to work earlier. That's what I did. Okay, bro. So, Martin, just let me know when. Just email me. On Friday, this Friday. What I did, I tell you this right now, like I didn't start teaching, okay? Because I had 2 sessions in the college. I taught from 9 to 1 and then again from 6 to 10, right? I got to the college, depending on where I worked at one campus, which is further from my home. So I don't have to get there till 9, but I got there at 6 in the morning. When I moved closer to my home, I got there at 7 in the morning, 2 hours before I got to start teaching. Why? So I can prepare. And then in the afternoon, there's an afternoon break. I have like, from 9 to 1, I got from 1 o'clock again till 6 o'clock free. Do I Do I leave? No, I stay. I stay at the campus. And what do? I configure all everything. Everything that I'm going to do in the evening or whatever, or early when I practice, I practice. Or if I'm going for a certification, I got 20 desktops, switches, routers, everything I need. So I go in there and stay configured. I don't leave. There was a gentleman that I worked with in telecommunications. He was always there an hour early. Okay. And anytime this, and he would never, they had to tell him to punch out. Because he had stuff to do, he kept doing it. He never looked at the clock. He just had to get things done. The manager said, listen, you can't, they're telling me you're getting too much overtime. You need to leave. Do that. You have tasks that you need to do in IT. Every day you have tasks. Complete that task. And then ask for another one. One of the things that I learned was, when you complete one task, is there anything else we need to do? Is there any task that we can maybe start doing now, working on? What else is there needs to be done? Ask questions. What do you want me to do? What is next on the calendar? If not, find something. If not, learn something. Don't leave. Don't look at the clock. The clock is non-existent. Okay? You go there early. I was always in the mindset of being an hour early wherever I go. So in my job at telecommunications, I think I started at 8. I was there at 7. Because I like to start getting my things ready. Okay, what's the plan for today? I talked to the team leads, whatever the case were. Hey, Laz, this is what you need to do today. But all right, cool. So I get myself ready. So, and I start working. So what if I, because our supervisor didn't care, our manager didn't care, we clocked in early. So I clocked in early and I started working. Okay. Until they tell me, Laz, you can't clock in early anymore. Okay. I still work. And then when it comes time to clock in, I clock in. Because they would get pissed when I would be working and I forget to clock in. Because then the manager's kind of fixed the time clock. So he would get pissed at that. But don't get into that mindset of 9 to 5. Don't. This is your, if you work for IT, work it like it's your company. How can a person with physical security and surveillance and man traps and access control background with some IT training transition to a specialized area? So you want to specialize in, you want to get into security, I'm assuming. Because that right there, that's all about security right there. You start, get your security plus. That's studying for your security plus. That's what you want to get into, right? In security. I mean, you're already doing security as it is. Okay. So stick to that track. That's what you know. Okay. Because it's going to be a very easy transition for you to get into security and IT. If you start going the route and IT and security, it will be easy to transition into that, especially with your background. Okay. So do that. That's how you would do it. If you're insecure right now, because right now, you know, physical security, nobody pays attention to. Nobody. Why are people walking into any place? Why isn't there somebody standing guard there? Why? Why are people allowed? I remember when I would take my stepdaughter to school or even my daughter, I would just walk right into the school. Why isn't there nobody? Why aren't there not guards on the perimeter of the school stopping people from coming in? Why are they not biometrics or certain cars? Why are teachers don't have bracelets? All right, Bluetooth bracelets, wireless bracelets for setting off alarms. Why isn't that? Where there's somebody goes insane in the classroom, just click your bracelet, boop, and then everybody knows what's going on. They run to where you're at. You have special teams. Yeah, why aren't IP cameras set up in every hallway in the schools? So this is physical security is like non-existent sometimes in IT. We just leave things wide open, okay? And as far as, not having that mindset of, hey, we need to make sure that nobody gets access to this, nobody gets access to that, writing policies out, all these things, people don't do it there. Because in IT, they get into their comfort zone. I've been here for 15 years, and I got me a captain's chair, and I got me a cup thing, a cup holder sitting right here, and I'm not going anywhere. And you start getting like this. You started off like this, like my frame, and then you start getting like this. But that's all you do. You sit and you do nothing and you're not active. You got to be active. You got to be actively involved. If you work in IT, that is your network. That is your servers. That is your hard drive. That is your cabling. You need to be responsible for that equipment. I don't care if the other person's not responsible. Do you know how many? There are people where I worked at that they're already, going out the door anyway due to their years being there, but they just didn't care anymore. They just didn't care anymore. And whether they did something or not, I beg, please give me this to do. Please give me this to do. Please give me this to do. And the bad thing about that is, you know what, Royale, is that people, when you do that, they start calling you a kiss ass, a brown nose. No, bro, I'm here to work. I didn't come here to play. Okay. And as I work, I learn. As I run into problems and break things, I fix them. I learn. Okay. And I want to be somebody who's productive. I'm hungry. I'm passionate. I don't want to be here counting the minutes in the clock. I want to be here to, you know, I'm excited about what I do. I love what I do. So just keep going and going and going and going and going. That's just the way it is. Okay. And look, nothing to do with IT. Nothing to do with IT. Thanks, Laz. I was a casino security command operator and investigator. Brother, if you are that, you're the perfect fit for security, my man. Start working from Security Plus on your way up. You'll fit right in. That's just going to be second nature to you. Okay. I remember working in warehousing. When I started working in warehousing, I would pick up pallets one at a time, you know, walking around, dumping things, putting boxes, taping, you know, carrying things, climbing up the friggin' racks. I was just a crazy individual, okay? I would do all these things. And people came to me, hey, man, you're working too fast, you know? You got to slow down. You're making us look bad. What is this, the mafia coming to me? No, you need to keep up, my man. I ain't going to slow down for nobody. I'm not going to be here looking at the clock. I'm going to be here working. They're going to have to tell me to go home. And every time there was overtime, I want it. I want overtime. Why? Because I need the money. I was in a previous marriage. That's what I call my other life. Okay. And I had to pay bills. So if there's overtime, I want it. Okay. Who wants to come in early? I do. Okay. So you volunteer for that because you're going to be the one that they're going to keep when they fire everybody else. Bottom freaking line. Because you are the hard worker. Now, I can tell you right now that that's a double-edged sword, honestly. Because when they, it is a double-edged sword because I've been in situations, all right, where I didn't know anything. A surveying company. I'm not going to mention the name of the company. I didn't know anything about surveying. Zero. And there's different positions in a surveying company, right? You got the rodman, you got the instrument man, and the party chief, right? So the rod man, he brings in the ice. He holds the rod so they can take the measurements. He has, simple things. You know, you do all the hard work. Then you have the instrument man who's actually looking through the equipment, turning the angles, all the stuff, right? And the party chief does all the calculation. Within a year, I became a junior party chief because I wanted to learn. And luckily, there was a person there. His name is Paul Messinelli, one of the best besides the guy in Metro PCS Switch, Chuck. He was like, this guy, he's the one that told me nobody's born a Switch technician. He's the one that gave me he let me, you know, come in, and all the guys there were wonderful and they trained me, right? But you got to be hungry. You got to show that you want. I still have lack of knowledge of IT, as I would call it, because I never know enough. Nobody ever knows everything. You're always learning. So that's the reason I always want to do as much work as I. Yes, you're good. You're good to go. Keep doing what you're doing. You think I don't have lack of knowledge? I got lack of knowledge. Everybody's lacking knowledge. Somebody just asked me a question on that ERP and SAP. I couldn't answer that. Should I know that? No, I shouldn't know that. Maybe I should. I don't know. Okay. Some people have experienced that. I haven't. Now I will. Now I'm going to look into it. I'm going to learn it. That's just the way it is. And that's why I have a website called thenetworkingdoctors.com. That's how I started up, right? Globed.net is my school, my e-learning platform. But my website, let me share it with you guys. If you guys have never seen it, we haven't done anything with it, really. We need to update it. Let's see if it even pops over. I'm just going to let it run there. Come on, man. What's going on with this internet? I'm being hacked. Are you guys hacking me? All right. Is it enter in? Really? Whatever. If it loads, it loads. But it's called thenetworkingdoctors.com. And the reason I chose that name is because IT personnel, whatever area you're in IT, you're a doctor. You will always be learning. Always. All the time. See, look at that. Site can be reached. Really? Really? Oh, there it is. It finally loaded. Look, check it out. This is my actual website right here. Okay? Products, boot camps, seminars, right? Here I am right here. I introduce things here. Learn with Laz, all this stuff. We haven't done anything with it, but we will. We're going to start updating it this year. Okay? We're going to start updating it this year. That was my networkingdoctors.com website. But I called it that because we are doctors. Laz, do you ever think of starting an ISP because you have a lot of knowledge on it, man. Believe it or not, the thought has crossed my mind, not because of one individual that I've been speaking to. Yeah, the thought has crossed my mind. The thought has crossed my mind. And yeah, it has. It has. I got my phase. I got my CCNA when I landed my first job. All devices are non-Cisco. Ain't that lovely? It's good to keep studying everything. Yes, it is, phase. Yes, it is. Yes, it is. I mean, because you got to take what comes. And you know what's cool? Because everybody gets their Cisco certs. They get their CompTIA certs. They get their Security Plus. You get all these mainstream certifications. And then you go work with somebody. Because right now, I put up, we fixed Teachable. And we have, here you go. Here, let me put it up here. Okay. We have Tomislav back with the MikroTik failover configurations, secure IT with firewall. We got him back up. Okay. I don't know what the heck happened, but he's up there now teaching MikroTik again. And he's a good instructor. You know what I'm saying? So definitely that's something you always want to keep learning new stuff. I found your videos a while ago from a video on subnetting. You're a very good instructor and I wish you the best. Thank you, Bill. I appreciate that, man. I appreciate that. And again, I always tell everybody out there, listen, if you got, things that I haven't shown or you want to see or whatever, let me know. Let me know, because I'm always like right now, after I'm done here, maybe I'll take a little break. I'm going to look up ERP and SAP and see all the technologies that are involved. I'm not going to become an expert at it, but at least I'll be able to answer the next person that asks me, a little bit more logical, maybe where to go to get information. That's just me. And yeah, you got to be a learner for life in IT. Things are changing. Look how much things change. I mean, think about this. I was thinking about this with my wife the other day. The certifications for Cisco changed February, was it 24th? 2020. February 24th, 2020. And they announced it October of 2019. That's November, December, January. They give you 4 months. Not that they came up with a new version of the test. I'd say continue, man. And you won't regret it. You have heard. Yeah. Definitely. It's Lewis. L-U-I-S. L-U-I-S. Lewis. Just so you know, because that looks like Louise. It's Lewis. What the hell was I just saying? I just freaking forgot what I was saying. My God, I just said, I'm always learning. You gotta be a learner constantly, and you just gotta be curious. And when I was a teacher in brick and mortar, and I worked in I can tell you right now, when I first started out, I printed out my cards and I just passed it out. I remember this doctor, I think she was a foot doctor, I don't recall. She had two companies, one in Miami, one in Miami Beach. She had an issue with wireless. She couldn't get her wireless up. And my partner at the time, he went there. He spent just a couple hours, maybe 2 or 3 hours. He couldn't get it working. I spent there, I don't know how many hours. And I finally figured out what the problem was. And it was a security issue. It was like a policy that was blocking him from getting it, right? But I stayed there until I fixed the problem. I didn't leave. It's like if you were to work for, my wife worked for Bell South 411, and I applied at one point, believe it or not, at 911. And one of the things that they told you at 911, and my wife told me the same thing for 411, you're an emergency disaster person. So if a hurricane or a catastrophe befalls, your state or your county or whatever the case may be, you ain't going home. I remember in the switch, we had a storeroom full of food and snacks and water and all that stuff, because they told me a story that one time they had to stay there 3 days. I think it was during a hurricane, right? They couldn't go home for 3 days. They slept at the switch and they have food right there, okay? That's just the way it is. Sometimes in IT, you don't go home until the problem is fixed. IT is not 9 to 5. This ain't Dolly Parton, okay? Working 9 to 5, what a way to make a living? Yeah, no. This is, IT is 24/7, okay? Until it's fixed, you do not leave. And if you have shift and somebody else is coming over, you better do a soft transfer. All right, man, take it easy later. Yeah, that's what's going on. Bye. No. Say, listen, this is the situation. This is what I've done. Document, you want me to stay to help you out, whatever. And, you got to be like that. If you're not a person that's not like that, you will not get picked for crap and people will see you like, whatever. But again, like I said, there's one individual in the telecommunications, he was put up on a pedestal. Okay. Me in surveying. That's where I was going. In surveying, that I didn't know anything, and I became a junior part chief within a year. It takes usually 5 years. But I'm hungry. Okay, I'm hungry. I want money. I want to work. I want to show that I got my tire slashed. People wanted to fight me every day. People complained about me every day that I was a brown noser and I was this and I was that. Okay. And I remember one day that I didn't go to work. I was sick or whatever. I don't know. I just didn't go to work that day. My crew got in trouble for not wearing roll guard vests on the street. I came back the next day to say, hey, lads, you got to sign this disciplinary action. I go, why? Because your crew didn't wear their roll guard vest on the street. I go, well, how is that my fault? I wasn't there. Who was the person in charge? Well, no, but it's your crew. I go, I'm not signing that. I've been like this all my life. I'm worse now. I'm not going to sign that. You change it from disciplinary to let me know, hey, they need to go this. Okay. So he goes, oh, okay, don't worry about it. Just let it happen again. I go, I wasn't here. So I can accept certain things, but if I wasn't even there, no. So being an overachiever for me has labeled me it's funny because this movie, a smart ass, a kiss ass, a brown nose. Okay. You know, it's like, no, dude, why would I want to come to work to sit on my butt, look at the clock, complain, and not do anything? How about learning everything you possibly can that's there, especially in 19? Now, it's all good, Martin. It's all good. Just letting you know. All right. You know what I mean? How about learning everything that's there? I don't care if you're in a warehouse or you're frigging CC or an architect, okay, for Cisco. You know, you need to be involved and you need to know, okay? So, and you need to keep up with everything, because if you're in a management position, eventually you're going to forget everything you learn in the trenches. And then that really sucks, okay? Because then the guy in the trenches, you're not a good leader. You got to be a good leader. Okay, so you gotta learn every last thing you possibly can, wherever you at, wherever you are. And that's what I've been. If I'm in McDonald's, I was gonna be a manager, but I left. If I was in the service, I wanted to go as far as I could. If I'm in surveying, if I'm in warehousing, if I'm in now in IT, I can't believe I wrote 2 books. Okay, and now I'm it for IP. I'm the guy. You want an IP? This is the person you need to go to. Okay, nobody else. So that's just the way it is. I'm always looking to excel. I'm always looking to learn more things. And that's what you need to do. But you need to put yourself, you need to give yourself credit. Because everybody on here is damn good at what they do. Okay? Got to go. Take care, Anthony. Take care, brother. We'll be talking soon. All right? You're good at what you do. And look at Anthony. Take his example in my interview that I had with him. Through the pandemic, he moved up. Okay, he put his head down and kept working. Okay, so you need to do what you're good and you're worth money. Now, you got to accept the fact that if you're walking into somewhere, okay, I don't have skills, I'll take this job, I'll learn what I can. If I don't see anything moving, then I start looking for something else, something better, and then move. Because the day or the year or the era of working for a job for 20 years, 30 years, that's over, man. That's over. There's no more Social Security. There's no more Golden Watch. Gotta go. Okay, yeah, I already read that. Okay. There's no more of that. Okay. Now is you. What can you do? And then keep moving. Keep moving. Keep swinging. You know, keep jabbing. Keep jabbing right there until where you get to where you want to be. And then keep going and keep going. That's why this year I'm putting out that course so you guys can do what I do. All right. If you want, it's up to you. It could be something you do on the side as a hobby and make an extra 10 G's a year. You know what I mean? So you can do this, okay? You can do this, but never stop learning, okay? Never stop learning. Hold yourself accountable for your learning. Hold your instructors accountable for their teaching. Don't disrespect, just hold them accountable. Ask the questions, okay? And let's see, okay? But you need to continuously improve yourself every single day until you're dead and buried in the frigging ground. Until the last breath leaves your last words should be, is the Cat 5 plugged in? You know, whatever. Okay. That's what your last words need to be. All right. That's just the way it is. You need to have that type of drive and motivation, and that's going to get you where you want to go. those that work hard, those that bust your butt, you know, 9 out of 10 times you will get rewarded. It'll be the 10th time that'd be like, ah, the hell with him. He's too good for us. So, you know, we want to make our own little crappy group. Okay. So no fear, learn, hold people accountable to include yourself and back yourself up against the wall and make yourself learn things you don't know. Okay. But again, I wanted to put that thing there. So take a look at it, ladies and gentlemen, the salary range, right? The salary ranges and the requirements. Okay. That's why you really got me upset. That's how I began this thing. How are you going to give somebody flipping burgers $31,000 a year when you got an IT guy who's making almost the same thing and he's got to learn from top to bottom? Come on. Anyway, keep learning. Take advantage of my 69% off using January surprise, any self-paced course. And you know you all need IPv4 courses. All right. It's 69% off. I'll put you in my you'll get an invitation to go to my prior Facebook group. And then I'll see when everybody's there, that's done and over with. We're going to do a little webinar for Q&A. Okay. But again, subscribe to GlobeEd, the Networking Doctors on YouTube, Instagram. Okay. It's been rolling on that little thing all this time. All right. Because I there's a new question up on Instagram. So ask questions and just stay active. Just stay active and do what you got to do. All right. I'll let you guys go. Thank you for joining. I'll see you next time.